Hello everyone, my name is Flying Dutchy and welcome to a new Let's Play series in Europa Universalis 4. And you could vote on me on which nation I should play next, and the winner is Ireland, an Irish nation. And we will do this in this Let's Play series, and we will go for an achievement, and this one is called Luck of the Irish. For this achievement we need to own and have course on all of the British Isles as an Irish nation. And that's what we are going to do. So let's jump into the game. So if you want to play as an Irish nation, you have to choose from one of these four: Leinster, Munster, Connaught and Tyrone. And I will play for Connaught. And this is because of their military skill. They have a leader that has 3 military power. But also, if we take this nation, we are the closest to Greenland and Newfoundland here. So this nation can colonize the fastest of all of these. That is why we will take Connaught. Okay, let's jump into the game. Turn on Ironman mode. Let's have a look at the options. Is it alright? Yeah, we will use dynamic provinces. Historical, we cannot change it. There is no custom setup in achievement run. Alright, let's click play. And I already have a save file. There it is. And let's jump into the game. So before we are going to start this Let's Play series, I really have to thank you guys for watching and subbing. I have almost 10,000 views already in not even 1.5 months that I'm doing this YouTube thing. So it's really incredible, and yeah, thank you for that, really. Also 60 subscribers, it's just fantastic. And this also helps me to keep me motivated, and I will continue these Let's Play series for you. And this series will also be only for YouTube. I will not stream it on Twitch. And this has some benefits, because the quality of the videos will improve in this Let's Play series. If you stream on Twitch, you can only have a bitrate of 3,500 kilobits per second. Yeah, and now we don't have to stream it on Twitch, so we can use 9,000 or 10,000 if we want to. And that's what I'm doing, so the quality will improve significantly. So, let's jump into the game. And oh yeah, one more thing before we start. This is in patch 1.13 and not in patch 1.12.2. That has some benefits, but also some, well, really annoying things actually. Normally in 1.12 I would ally Scotland right away, but if I do this, it's not possible anymore to get France as an ally, because when we get Scotland we get a modifier, and that modifier says that you have that you already have a major power ally, and that's a minus 25 or a minus 50 opinion to get a second big power ally. So the goal will be to ally Scotland and France at the same time. That's the only way you get two big allies at the start of the game. And yeah, we can do it in two ways, this Let's Play series. We can do it the hard way and the easy way. The easy way is to get to Admin Technology 5. So we can unlock our first idea group. We go exploration. And we rush to the Americas. This way we can set our capital there, and we can grow in America as our home continent. So you won't form any colonial nations there, and the land that you get there is all yours. It's just like in Europe then, when we set our capital in the Americas. The hard way is that we don't colonize, but that France and Scotland will help us to take on England, and that way we should get focus on military power, so we can outtake England with their military skill. They have a very crappy king, a 0-0-0, if we focus on military, there is a point in the game that we have two military technologies in advance from England. And that's a way that we can beat them, I think. And I think I will try to do the hard way. But if something happens in the game and we are getting crushed, then we should go colonize and take on Great Britain later. So I will rush to the exploration ideas, I think. And in the meantime, just stack up our military. Okay, I'm going to set up the game. As Connaught, you can only rival your Irish neighbors, so let's do this. There we go, we have set our rivals. We will not take any advisors, and this is because of our income. It's crap, really. It's really crap. But in patch 1.13, every Irish nation starts with 3 heavy ships. They are way too expensive. So what I'm going to do at the start is sell these ships. I will sell one to Scotland, and I think I will sell one to Brittany and one to Castile. And they will pay 60 gold for each one. So we make a lot of income from that. And that is what I'm going to do at the start. It's very important that we are going to improve relations with France right from the beginning. Otherwise, we will never get France as an ally. It's some distance here. Our army strength is very low, and we have a neutral attitude. So yeah, it's essential that we get France, so France can attack England, he can call us in. So we can take Meath from England that way. And we could also attack England at some point. Call France and Scotland in. So we will get some war score from the mainland here. So if we lose in Scotland and Ireland, France still has these provinces here. And I think that way we can still win the wars. So let's try to do that. What should we do more? I should take a mission. And I will take this one, remove Tyrone from the map, so we get a claim instantly on Tyrone. And I think that is the setup. Yeah, I should... Oh, Barks. They need to protect trade in the English trade node here. The English Channel trade node. We could protect trade here, but there's almost no income in the North Sea trade node. We only have one province in it, so we don't make that much here. What I will do is set my merchant to collect trade in here, in this trade node, the North Sea one. And collect trade in the English Channel. There we go. And when the merchant arrives here, I can send my trade fleet to protect the trade there. It's not possible now because our merchant is not here. But when it arrives, I can click on the English Channel trade node. And it will give us a bit more income here. So no advisors, and we will keep improving the France. We should claim a bit from the other Irish nations. And we should also get to our force limit right away. And the rest of the money we will build barks. I will sell my transports. I will not, disband them. I will not sell them. We don't almost make any money from them. I will only sell my heavies. And I think that's the start of this campaign. There is a high possibility that we have to start over again, and maybe, well, you know, 2, 3, maybe 4 times. Because there is a chance that one of the Irish nations will attack me. And if that happens, well, they will ally each other and they will attack my country here, and then I'm screwed when I don't have Scotland or France as an ally. There could also be a possibility. No, we cannot ally any of the Irish nations because they are our rivals. So we need to be a bit lucky. Okay, this is the start. This is my explanation. Hopefully see you in part 1 when we will start the game. And the first days will be improving the front, get the alliances of Scotland and France, claim the lands here, take all of Ireland, and maybe strike England when we have two military attacks in advance, when they get some rebels, for example. They will have the War of the Roses at some point. Maybe we can ally Denmark later on. And then we will try to conquer Great Britain. So this is the end of this quick video. So again, thank you for watching, thank you for subbing, and give me a like, give me your opinion about the videos. I think that's very important, so I know how I can improve myself, or maybe you have some tips for me, just tell me, and you know, maybe I will do something with it. If you have any questions about the game, just ask them. I will try to help you to figure out this game. So, see you in the next part. Bye bye.